Hello everyone. So now we are going to see the topic called point-to-point protocol. So by the name itself, we can say that if you want to make a communication point-to-point, so if you want to do a point-to-point communication, then we can use this protocol called point-to-point protocol. Okay, so today millions of internet users, if they want to connect their home computers to the server, they will be using this point-to-point protocol. So if they want to connect home computers with the servers, they will be using point-to-point protocol to connect the computers with the servers. Okay, so here we are going to see the services they are provided by the point-to-point protocol, and we are going to see the framing formats, everything over here. First, we will see what are the services provided by point-to-point protocol. First, initially, the first service it is going to provide is authentication. So when we are going to connect between two devices, we need an authentication like login credentials, login ID and password. We need to check whether the identity of the user is valid or not. So for that, we can have an authentication. So if the authentication is proper, then we can allow to do the data transfer. Okay, that is one of the services that is done by the point-to-point protocol. The second service is frames. So it is going to send frames from one data link layer of one device to the another device. That is also one of the device. In today's a new point-to-point protocol, it will also support multi-link calls, multi-link. So usually point-to-point protocol will help us to connect between only two devices. If you want to do with multiple devices, so newer version of point-to-point protocol will allow this multiple links concept also. So these are the services that is provided by point-to-point. Next, we will see what are the services which are not provided by point-to-point. First, coming to this, so here it will not provide flow control. So flow control is not being done in point-to-point. It will support only error control. So this is the drawback we have in point-to-point protocol. So next, we will see the framing. So when we come to the framing, we have flag, then we have the address, control information, protocol information, payload is a data where we have to send the data, and frame check sequence and flag. So this flag at both at the beginning and the end will tell us it will act as a delimiter. So this will be the beginning of the frame and this will be the end of the frame. So usually it will be of 1 byte. So it is of 1 byte, and the flag pattern will be 6 ones followed by 0. So when you have this particular pattern in the beginning and also the end, it means that it is where the frame starts and this is where the frame ends. Okay, the flag is used as a delimiter. And next is an address field. So here the address we need to provide where that particular frame has to get on or it has to reach. So this is what the address. Suppose if we are going to use if you are going to do a broadcast, then the address field will be all ones. All the values it will be set to ones. Next is a control field. Control field, usually we have seen in HDLC protocol itself, control field will help us to do the flow control and error control. So all those information, it will be available. But since this point-to-point protocol does not support flow control, so only error control information is available in control byte, control this format. And then we have the protocol. So this protocol, everything is of 1 byte. The flag, 1 byte, address, control. And coming to the protocol, it is of 1 or 2 bytes. It is based on the protocol what we are going to use. So this protocol will tell you whether what type of data we are going to send in the payload, whether we are going to send a data information, or we are going to use the data information, or we are going to send any system information. Okay, this is what we are going to have it in the protocol. Next, coming to the payload. Payload will contains actual data. So actual data, the maximum size of this data will be 1500 MB. So this 1500 bytes. So this is what, this is the size of the data which you can send it through the format, through this frame. Last is frame check sequence. Frame check with sequence, it is of 2 bytes. It will be of 2 to 4 bytes. Okay, and flag is 1 byte. So 2 to 4 bytes. So this frame check sequence, it will tell you, it will be useful when we are going to use the cyclic redundancy codes. As we have discussed in error detection and correction, we have discussed one of the technique is cyclic redundancy codes. So in that, we will be sending some cyclic codes or redundancy codes for correcting the errors or detecting the errors. So for that, we will be using this particular information, okay, FCS. So this is all about the framing, okay. So next we will see the next concept. So point-to-point protocol, next, it is a byte-stuffing method. It is a byte-oriented protocol. It is a byte-oriented. We have two types of protocol like bit-oriented and byte-oriented. This point-to-point is byte-oriented protocol. So whenever a data, if inside the data, if any flag pattern appears inside the data, so we will be stuffing a byte. So we will be stuffing this particular byte before any flag appears or before any escape character. So when inside the data you have flag pattern or any escape character appears, so what happens is this particular byte will be inserted before the flag or before the escape. This is to tell that this is not the, if we encounter this flag pattern inside the data, so the receiver will think that this is the end of the data. So to avoid this confusion, so we are going to stuff with one byte. That is, this byte will be stuffed before the flag or escape character. So this point to point is byte stuffing method. Next we will see the transition phases. So coming to the transition phases, so this is what we have in transition phase. So first we have the dead state. Initially, we will draw this with the help of finite state machine. So in this finite state machine, so first initially we are going to start. So if any data we needs to be communicated, if data to be transferred from one device to another device, so it will check for the carrier. If any carrier is detected, that means if you want to send any data between the two devices, that is carrier is detected. So what happens is it will go into the established state. So in this established state, if the carrier detected is failed, if it is failed to detect the carrier, it will again go to the dead state. Okay, next, now we are in the established state. So now what we can do is, as I have told you, point to point protocol mainly concentrate on authentication. So if authentication is required, if any other device wants to check your identity, then we can go for authentication process. So from the authentication process, so what happens is it will go into the network part. So if you are not going for authentication, it can directly goes to the network part here. So it will directly goes to this. If the authentication fails also, if authentication failed, that is, it is not proper, the identity is not a valid one. So it will goes to terminate state, where it will drop the carrier and it will goes to the dead state. Okay, this is what happens now. So when here what happens is point to point protocol, one more feature we have in point to point protocol is that it will support some of the protocols in network layer. So when we are going to transfer, when we are going to send the data, so data link layer only we are having this point to point. But what happens is that the receiver has to know what are all the other protocols which has been used in network layer. So what we have to do is we need to configure the network layer configuration. So in this we need to send all this network layer protocols also to the other side. So for that we need network layer configuration. So when it is open, now the data can be transferred. And from there, when it is done, it will go to the terminate state. So this is what the terminate state, and then from there carrier will be dropped, it will go again into dead state. So this is what happens in the transition phases. So when carrier is detected, it will go to the established state, and when authentication is required, it will go to this particular phase, and it will go to network for getting the protocols, for knowing what are all the protocols this network layer is going to use, and for this it is going to create one configuration. After this, data transmission will take place and will go to terminate state, and from there it goes to dead state. So this is what the transition phase is. Next is we will see the multiplexing. So here multiplexing it will support some other set of protocols also for communication. So the first protocol it supports is link control protocol. So link control protocol is mainly used for establishing or maintaining or configuring and terminating the link. So if a link has been established between the two devices, so for establish the link, or we have to maintain the link for proper data transfer, or configuring the link or terminating the link, we use a sub protocol called link control protocol, which is carried out by PPP. So now next, other two authentication protocols also supports this PPP. That is, one is password authentication protocol and CHAP, challenge handshake authentication protocol, that we will be seeing later. And network control protocol. This network control protocol, I told you, like, it needs some network layer protocols also. It has to know what all the network protocols are used in during data transmission. For that, we have this network control protocol. So it is a combination of all the three: link control, two authentication protocols, and network control protocols. So if you see in this diagram, this is a diagram for multiplexing. So this is a network layer, and we have NCP, network control protocol, authentication protocol, two authentication protocols are there, and next we have link control protocols over here. If we see the flag format, so we have frame format, you have flag, then we have the address format, address field, and we have control field. Next is protocol field, to know what type of protocol we are going to use, and here the data, it comes from the network layer, we place it here, and we have frame, check sequence, and then flag. So other three protocols which is supported in the data link layer. So now this protocol, if you are going to, this is an hexadecimal number, so if we are going to use LCP, link control protocol, means in this place we need to mention 0xc021, it is an hexadecimal number. If you are going to use an authentication protocol, any of the two authentication protocols, then we can write 0xc023 and c0xc223. So any of the protocol can be mentioned here. Or if you are going to use network control protocols, so then we can use 0x8021. So this is what it is a combination of all the three protocols. It is given in one simple diagram. Okay. Now we will see in detail about link control protocol. So coming to link control protocol, as we have told you, it is mainly used for establishing the link. For establishing the link and for maintaining the configuring, all those purpose will be using link control protocol. So this is the frame format, flag, address, and then we have control. So here the protocol, the number is 0xc021. That means that I'm going to use link control protocol for the frame. And payload information, here the data, you can have this information: code, ID, length, and information. So here and then at last we have frame, check sequence, and flag. Coming to the code, it can have all these codes over here. An ID will tell you what type of ID, how you are going to identify this particular frame, that ID, and what is the length of that particular message, and the information, actual message, you can set it here. This code will tell you what type of action you are going to perform. Suppose the code number is over here, the code number is present, the code number is, it is also 1 byte, ID is also 1 byte, and length is of 2 bytes, and then information you have. So if this code number is 0x01, it means that you are going to request for the configuration. And if the code is 0x02, it means that the receiving end has given you an acknowledgement that it has accepted all the options. Then next is 0x03. So this means that it announces that some options are not acceptable. So that is why it is sending negative acknowledgement, NAK. And fourth, it tells you that some of the options are not recognized. In that case, it will send you an option called configure reject. So for the first four codes is used for link configuration. This is used for link configuration. For configuring the link, you can use the first four codes. Like, either you can send the request, or the receiving end can send acknowledgement or a negative acknowledgement, or it can send reject also. Reject is used when that particular options are not recognized. Now we have 5, 6, 7, 5 and 6. These two codes are used for link termination. So what we'll do in link termination is, suppose we want to, someone needs to terminate the link. They have done all the data transfer, they need to shut down the link. So in that case, they can send the request, like terminate request, with this particular code. And terminate, if they accept, the receiving end accepted their request, then they can send terminate acknowledgement. Next 5 set of codes is used for link monitoring and debugging. So what it will do in link monitoring and debugging is, so this code reject 0x07, if you send, that means that it is called code reject. That means it is announces that the code is not recognized. It is sending the code contains some error in the code. So in that it will send code reject. And 0x08, it announces an unknown protocol. Suppose if you have, instead of using 0xC021, if you have given some other number, if the receiver cannot understand, in that case it will send protocol reject 0x08. And then next is echo message. For that, usually when you want to know other end is live or not, we'll be sending echo or hello message. So this echo request is being sent with the code 0x09. And they can reply it with 0x0a for replying for the hello message. And last is 0x0b, that is used for discard the packet. So when any request has been given to discard the packet. So these are the codes which you can use it here, and you can mention and you can give the message. So based on this, the receiver can understand what type of request it has been carried out while during transmission. Okay, this is all about link control protocol. So control protocol is mainly used for establishing and terminating the link and configuring the link. So this is what the frame format we need to use when you are going to use link control protocol. Next is password authentication protocols. Authentication protocols, it plays an important role, because you need to know the validity of the user. So for checking the validity of the user, you can use this. Validity of the user, we can use this authentication protocol. So there are two protocols which supports this authentication. One is password authentication protocol, and the next is CHAP, that is challenge handshake authentication protocol. Okay, first coming to password authentication protocol. So this password authentication protocol is a simple authentication protocol. It'll have only two step process. The first step process, user will have to communicate with the system, and it will send an authentication identification. That is, for example, it will send a login ID and login password. Okay, so if authentication information, identification will be sent. And after which the system, the other end devices, they can able to accept that login, or if they can able to reject the user also. So it will checks for the validity. So you can write authentication acknowledgement, or they can go for authentication negative acknowledgement. That means that they have not allowed to create the data transfer or to create the link for data transfer. Okay, it's a two-step process. The first step, the user will send authentication identification to the system. The system will send, based on the checking, it will verify the user, and if it is a valid user, it will allow to send the data. So it is authentication acknowledgement, or it can send authentication negative acknowledgement. So this is a frame format. We know flag, and then we have address control. C023 is used to represent your password authentication protocol, as we have already seen. And then payload, frame check sequence, flag. First coming to the payload, so it can take three formats over here, this payload. Either we can represent code 1. If it is code 1, it means that we are going to send an authentication request and the ID of this particular frame, and then length of the data which you are going to send, username length. What is the username for the length of that username, and what is the username you are going to give, and password length and password. So this is the, suppose if you are going to send an authentication request frame from the sender to the receiver, you have to use this particular format. The second is the receiver, other end, the receiver wants to send the format to this, if they want to reply to this message. So in that case, they can use an code 2. If they have accepted the user, then they can give code 2, ID, length, and message length, and then last we have your username. So to which user they have validated. Next is authentication negative acknowledgement. If the receiver do not want to allow data transfer, so in that case they can send code 3, ID, length, message length, and username. So this is all about password authentication protocol. So this is mainly used for checking the validity of the users. So for that, we have this particular frame formats in the payload. Okay, now we will see the next protocol called challenge handshake. Challenge handshake authentication protocol. So this is a more secure protocol and than the password authentication protocol. Okay, so here it is a three-way handshake. The first, the user will have to send a request. Okay, the system has to send the user a challenge. So they will be asking a challenge from the receiver end. They will be sending it to user for a challenge. So if the user has sent, it will send the response of the challenge. So if this is success or failure, then they will again will send the reply message. So this is what we have. That's why we are saying it is three-way handshake. First the system will communicate with the user for the challenge. So it will give you some challenge. It will ask you to calculate those challenge value. So now the user will find out that calculation. It will send the response along with that username and password. It will send it to the receiver end. So now the receiver has to check whether the challenge is correct and the username and password is correct. Everyone is correct. Then it will go for either telling success or failure. So it's a three-way handshake program. So it is, now we will see the frame format. So flag, address, control, this is the protocol which has to be used for CHAP. Then payload, in this we have four set of codes we can have: frame, check, sequence and flag. First coming to this, if the code is one, it means that it is called a challenge. We are going to send a challenge code from the system to the user. So ID and then length of that message. What is a challenge length and what is the challenge value you want to calculate, and then we have the name. So this is used to send the challenge value. It is usually some few bytes. Next is the code 2 is like the, now the user will send the response with the code 2 by calculating the challenge value, and then it will also send the name. That is, you have ID length, response value and name. So usually the challenge value is something like when you enter some websites, so they'll be asking for calculation 4 plus 2. So in that case, if you return the calculated part and also you have given username and password, if everything is correct, it will allow you to log in. So this is also one type of this three-way handshake protocol. Next one is success. So in that case, so after receiving the response, it will find out whether that value is correct. If it is correct, it will send the success with the code 3. So ID, length and message. And if it is failure, it will send you the code with 4. ID, length and message. This is what all about your CHAP protocol. So in CHAP protocol, first the system will send the challenge value, and now the user will send the response. Now this system, it will either it can accept the challenge or it can do not allow that particular user. So this is all about your CHAP protocol. The next, the last protocol which we need to know is network control protocol. Network control protocol, what it will do is it will carry network layer data packets from the sender side to receiver side. So when we are going to create a communication link by using link control protocol, and then we are going to check for authentication, after which we need to send some of the network layer data packets along with the data. So for that we are using network control protocol. One specific protocol which supports this NCP is IPCP. So what do you mean by IPCP? Is it is Internet Protocol Control Protocol. So what it will do is that it will carry IP packets in the internet. So several network layer protocols are available in the network layer. So suppose if the data link layer, if they want to send network layer data packets also into the transmission, that case they need to use this particular protocol called NCP. Okay, so now we will see that IPCP format. for this. So if you see this, we have flag address control, and then we have to mention MCP protocol protocol number and payload FCS and flag. So in this payload, it can take any value, code, ID, length, and ICP IPCP information. Coming to this code, it can take the values from here. So it can take a value like 0x01 02 03 04 05 and 06 and 07. So if it is 0x01, it means that you are going to create a request for the configuration. If it is 2, if it means that it configuration has been accepted with acknowledgement, and 0x03 is configuration is not accepted, so it is negative acknowledgement has been sent. 0x04 is for rejecting the acknowledgement. Like, what is the difference between negative acknowledgement and reject? Is negative acknowledgement will not accept some options, some of the options in the data will not accept, that is negative acknowledgement. Complete rejection is configure reject. And if you are going to send 5, it will be used for termination request. If you want to terminate that request, we can send this 5 code. And if you want to send the acknowledgement for the termination, you can send 6. At last 7, if the code is not recognized, if it is code is some other code if you have sent, so that code will be rejected. So this is all about your MCP protocol. So in this point to point protocol, what we have learnt is, we have learnt on the services for framing, and then we have learnt on transition phase, how many the transition phase, in which state it will move on, and then we have studied the multiplexing. Okay, and last we have seen authentication protocols, and last we have seen the authentication that is like we have seen on CHAP password authentication protocol, CHAP challenge handshake authentication protocol. At last we have seen NCP network control protocol. For that we are using IPCP protocol. Thank you.